centered around 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 23 through 26. And I'll be reading from the New American Standard Version. For I received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he also took the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." The elements that comprise the Lord's Supper are ordinary, made up of things we might eat and drink on a daily basis. What sets the Lord's Supper apart is its meaning. This sacred meaning was assigned to the meal by Jesus on the night he instituted it with his disciples. The observance of the Lord's Supper is a Christian practice handed down from Jesus to his disciples with the instructions for them to continue it. Jesus commanded the church to observe this tradition as a rite of remembrance. The Lord's Supper focuses our attention on Jesus' work on our behalf. Each element used in the meal highlights one aspect of this sacrifice. The bread points to the offering of Christ's body. The language highlights the nature of Christ's death on the cross. The cup points to Christ's blood, reminding us of his life, death, and resurrection. Jesus took the cup of blessing during Passover with his disciples and told them to drink of it. The new covenant, which was prophesied by Jeremiah, promised a transforming righteousness that would reorient lives toward God by changing the heart and providing forgiveness. The Lord's Supper is simple, but is not common. It reminds us that the only remedy for our sin is the work of Jesus Christ in his death and resurrection. Let's pray for the bread. Heavenly Father, we ask your blessings upon this bread and upon us as we eat it in remembrance of your Son and our Savior, Jesus Christ. It's in his name we pray. Amen. Now for the cup. Heavenly Father, as we take of this fruit of the vine in memory of Jesus, may our thoughts center around his creative powers, being thankful for him making us, making our world, and providing all things needful. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Just as a reminder, we're not passing the offering plates, as well as we just did not pass the communion elements. There are offering plates at the rear of the auditorium as you exit each door. If you would, just drop your contribution there. Also, visitors, if you haven't already, please fill out a white card for our record so we'll know that you're here or have been here. And you can drop that in the offering plate as well. And in front of you also, there's a blue card, blessing and needs. If you have a blessing or a need that you'd like one of the elders to pray for, you can complete that card and drop it in the offering plate. And the elders will pray for you or on your behalf for that. Kids to kids, thank you. While we're singing the next song, Chip will be up front
with his stuffed goat and the basket for our Kids to Kids program. If you have a bulletin, you'll see a little blurb about it on page 3 down at the bottom right. It explains what we're doing. We're buying goats for widows in India. So if you have any questions about that, you can see any member here or one of our elders, and we'll be glad to explain to you what's going on with that. Let's pray now for the offering. Heavenly Father, we worship you, a generous God who's for Jesus was both a gift and great giver. As followers of Jesus, we find our deepest joy in giving back to you, and that's why we give this offering cheerfully. In Jesus' name, amen. Oh, and cups away as you leave this morning.